is what your old razor can do. This is what our new Norelco rotary razor can do. The new Norelco rotary razor has twice as many rotary razor blades as ever before, safely protected inside three floating heads with nine adjustable razor settings for a comfortable shave that's razor close, razor smooth. It does everything your old razor can do, except...
Gotcha.
The new Norelco rotary razor. One electric that's earned the right to be called a razor.
Marie here is going on a little trip. Actually, not so little a trip. You see, this man who comes by for Snapdragons told me about a discount United Airlines is offering, 30% off. I said now's the time to go, because with this fare, I'll save more now than in the summer.
Save 30% on round-trip coach with United's Freedom Fare.
30% off? That's a lot of Snapdragons.
United Airlines.
Over the past 125 years, ovens have changed, but oven cleaners haven't. They all use lye, except Arm & Hammer Oven Cleaner. It cleans differently. All others leave a film coating you can actually feel and smell when you cook, so you have to wipe again and again. Ours turns to a dry residue which wipes away easily, even on baked-on grease. Arm & Hammer Oven Cleaner. No fumes, no gloves.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them spring. Fresh from the womb. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden's top lay.
Good night.
Did Peter Riley murder his mother? The jury said he did, but if you watch 60 Minutes this week, you may come away with a reasonable doubt. Sunday at 7, 6 Central. Monday night, CBS reports Inside the FBI with an examination of the myths and realities, the strengths and the weaknesses of our federal law enforcement agency.
International circus stars with entertainment for all ages. Thrill to the death-defying acts by the world's greatest circus talent. Join Bill Bixby at the high-flying Hamburg Circus.
Tomorrow at 8, 7 Central Time on CBS.
Our top stories tonight include the Supreme Court taking another look at the death penalty.
And John Cardinal Cody leads a pro-life mass tonight at the anniversary of the Supreme Court decision on abortion. We'll have details next on Channel 2 News.
John M. Smith's entire selection of bedroom furniture is on sale, dramatically reduced. These lovely four-piece sets are typical of the values you'll find, and there are over 30 bedrooms in every style and price range to choose from. On sale now at all 9 stores. And remember, if you're not satisfied with your furniture on delivery, you may return it to John M. Smith. Or do you say Smythe?
When you're really close, you don't want to worry about underarm odor. Now there's a more natural way to stay fresh when you're close. Arm in Arm, the first spray deodorant with baking soda. Arm in Arm gives real deodorant protection without harsh chemicals. It works without stinging or staining or clogging pores. New Arm in Arm by Helene Kurtis, the first spray deodorant with baking soda.
You and me, babe.
You and me,
Arm in Arm, naturally, baby.
Bet you don't know what's in here.
What?
A whole lot of peanuts.
And a little bit of magic.
I don't believe that.
It's true. I use a whole lot of fresh roasted peanuts. And a little bit of magic. That's what makes it taste so good.
I believe it, but I don't understand it.
If you believe in peanut butter, clap your hands.
For peanuts.
And magic.
If you believe in peanut butter, you gotta believe.
Come on, be a believer.
In Peter Pan.
WBBM-TV, Channel 2, Chicago. This is Channel 2 News with Bill Kurtis, Walter Jacobson, and the Channel 2 News team. John Coffin with the weather, Johnny Morris on sports.
Good evening. We are used to violence in Chicago, often take it for granted, but the shock lingers over an attempted rape in an elementary school classroom in front of frightened first graders. The assault was yesterday, but the story continued today on several fronts. First, the police. They produced a picture of the suspect from witnesses' descriptions. He is thought to be a dark-complexioned black man with a pockmarked face, believed to be between 18 and 20, with a slight build, tall, about 6 feet one, with an outstanding mark just above his slim mustache. On his left upper lip, a scar. Police have questioned several suspects since the attack. All have been released. The other developments came from the teachers. They took a closer look at where it happened, a mobile classroom at Guggenheim School. There are 4 mobiles there, 2 with phones, 2 without. The crime took place in one of the ones without communications. Teachers have complained about that problem. So has the Chicago Teachers Union. CTU President Robert Healy told newsmen the teachers are upset, but it's an old problem that's never been attended to.
And so on. We have had complaints for years with the Board of Education about proper signaling systems out of the mobile classroom.